Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome back to the IBFP, and we're the only channel that's telling you the truth. And look, let's just break it down. Vasily Lomachenko wants to be a great fighter. He doesn't want to be a good fighter. He wants to be great. He wants his name etched in stone. He wants to be undisputed. He wants to be one of the greatest that we've ever seen. And a lot of people go back and forth. Oh, he's afraid of Teofimo Lopez. He doesn't want to fight Teofimo Lopez. He's trying to lowball the guy. You hear all of this nonsense and madness. And I think that Teofimo versus Vasily Lomachenko is a great fight stylistically. Either guy could win. Lomachenko has elite level skills. Teofimo Lopez has elite level power. It makes for an exciting matchup, but we got to dig into the ultimate truth. And the ultimate truth is Vasily Lomachenko, according to reports, you know, this guy is taking a voluntary pay cut to help the Teofimo Lopez deal get done. And you know, Bob Arum's exact quote is, he has voluntarily, under these circumstances, reduced his own purse in order to get the fight done. So he's reducing his own purse to allow for Teofimo Lopez to get more money in a pot where there's no audience. There's no live gate. There's limited sponsorship. This man wants to be great. He wants to go for greatness. He wants to be one of the best. You can no longer deny that. You can no longer turn the blind eye. Anybody telling you that he doesn't want to be great, anybody telling you that he's not trying to get this fight done, is absolutely delusional or a Teofimo Lopez fanboy. We got to be honest and unbiased. And you know, you even see Bob Arum coming out and stating that, you know, and this is the exact quote, we explained to them that we have no live gate revenue, no closed circuit TV revenue. We're willing to pay him a big price, but again, I'm not going to lose millions of dollars on an event because Teofimo thinks he's worth more. And that makes perfect sense. Look, all of the boxing companies are hurting, promotional companies. Think about it. Top Rank, PBC, DAZN. None of these guys are overflowing with cash at the moment because the coronavirus has taken away their business to a degree. So you see, PBC, all of the fights they got made, they have to be on pay-per-view to try to guarantee these guys some money. You see, DAZN is struggling to get the biggest, you know, name in boxing and fighting Canelo Alvarez. You see, Top Rank, they have to be careful about how much money they spend on each and every event. This is the nature of the business during a pandemic. It makes perfect sense. And look, let's just be real. He's not going to waste money. He's not going to lose money. So that should even show you how incentivized Vasily Lomachenko is about getting it done. He's not trying to max out and say, well, I deserve $5-10 million for this fight. I shouldn't be taking this kind of risk. No, he's more interested in the accolades, the accomplishment, the legacy. And it's showing by what he's willing to give up and sacrifice to get that done. You know, Vasily Lomachenko could easily make another multi-million dollar payday just against anybody. He's choosing to give up more of his purse to take on Teofimo Lopez. And, you know, in an article stated, you know, by BoxingScene.com, they stated all the previous purses of, you know, Vasily Lomachenko's prior opponents. Jorge Linares, $1.2 million, you know, against Vasily Lomachenko. The exact same amount that's ordered, you know, that's offered to Teofimo Lopez. Now, some people say, well, why would they offer him the same amount they offered Jorge Linares? And, you know, the funny thing about this is people are so delusional, they don't realize there's no live gate. The promotion opportunities for sponsorships are not there. These guys don't have any of that extra revenue. So the fact that you're getting $1.2 million in a pandemic is absolutely astronomical. That's huge. You're not seeing these type of purses in a pandemic. That is massive. You know, you see Jose Pedraza earned $1 million. And all of these fights are within the live gate. You know, Rigo, $400,000. Sosa, $350,000. You know, Corolla, Nicholas Waters, $300,000. Mariaga, 50,000. So you see that Teofimo Lopez, based on what he's accomplished, he's not a pay-per-view superstar. He's not some massive name in a sport. He hasn't accomplished all these masterful things. He's only beaten Richard Comey. And so 1.2 million during a pandemic is a great deal. And the fact that Vasyl Lomachenko's lowering his purse to offer you more money, there's no more excuses for Teofimo Lopez. There's just absolutely none. He has to take this fight. This has to get done next. There's no excuse. This fight has to get done. And if it's not, it's going to be on Teofimo Lopez. And here's why. Teofimo Lopez is the clear B-side. This is a career high payday for Teofimo. He has a chance at greatness in all of the belts. Teofimo also has a chance to enter the pound-for-pound contention and conversation with the win over Vasyl Lomachenko. He can become an overnight superstar. And not to mention that he begged Vasyl Lomachenko, Bob Arum, and Top Rank for this fight, and now it's right in front of his face with a career-high payday. Vasyl Lomachenko is taking a pay cut to make this happen. This has to happen next, or it's an absolute duck for Teofimo Lopez. But once again, Unbiased as always, it's the IBFP.